Listen to the angels rejoicing and so sweetly receiving heaven's glory. The night that Christ was born.
I love to tell the story of joy and wondrous love. Now my Jesus and your Jesus left his home in glory, while angels marveled above. I love to tell the story because I know it's true. It satisfies my longings as nothing else can do. I love to tell the story. It is well my theme in glory to tell the old, old story of Jesus and your love and my love.
Napenda kuhubiri habari za Yesu, ya Bwana wa fahari, na pendo zake kuu. Kuhubiri napenda kwa hali na mali, mwenyewe ni najua ni kweli. Napenda kuhubiri kisa cha Bwana Yesu, ya Bwana wa fahari, na pendo zake kuu. Napenda kuhubiri mambo ya ajabu, na tukiyafikiri yapita dhahabu. Kuhubiri napenda yaliyonifaa, nami sana napenda hayo kukwambia. Napenda kuhubiri kisa cha Bwana Yesu, ya Bwana wa fahari, na pendo zake kuu. Napenda kuhubiri unifurahisha, tamu yake habari haiwezi kuisha. Napenda kuhubiri wagizani nao, hawana muhubiri wakwele za chuo. Napenda kuhubiri kisa cha Bwana Yesu, ya Bwana wa fahari, na pendo zake kuu. Kuhubiri napenda hata wajuao, kusikia upenda kama wenzi wao. Nako kwenye bahari nikiimba wimbo, nitaimba habari ya Mwokozi huyo. I love to tell the story, twill be my theme in glory, to tell the old, old story of Jesus and his love. Now bend enda kuhubiri kisa cha Bwana Yesu ya Bwana wa fahari na pendo lake kuu na pendo lake kuu.
I love to tell the story in any language, amen, it resonates in our hearts. And oh, what an amazing story it is. Let us recall the wonderful and miraculous events surrounding Jesus' birth. But first, let us take a glimpse into the heavenly courts. Can you imagine the excitement in heaven from the angel's perspective? The Son of God was going to give up his most adored position with God, the Father, in heaven, and set aside his divinity to come to earth as a helpless baby and live with the people on the earth that he had created. How would it happen? How long would Jesus be gone? Let us stand and raise our voices and join the heavenly host who sing the great anthem of praise, Gloria in Excelsis Deo. Glory to God in the highest, let us stand. Angels, we have heard on high. Angels, we have heard on high, sweetly singing o'er the plain, and the mountains in reply, echoing their joyous strain. Everybody, was a special night, a night that was different than all others, for this was the night when love was born.
My eyes to see the night when love was born. A perfect child gently waits, a mother bends to kiss God's face. I close my eyes to see the night.
long before Gabriel appeared to Mary in a host of angels, saying to shepherds on a hillside, the coming of a Messiah for the people of Israel had been predicted. Isaiah's word, prepare the way of the Lord, make his paths straight. Every valley shall be filled, and every mountain and hill shall be brought low, and the crooked shall be made straight, and the rough ways, they shall be made smooth. And all flesh shall see the salvation of God. Amen?
Amen.
Isaiah 43 and 4. With eagerness, the children of Israel awaited a king.
We know very little about Mary, the mother of Jesus. She was apparently very young when she was engaged to be married to a carpenter named Joseph, probably not much more than my age. Imagine this young girl's astonishment when she is visited by the angel Gabriel with the message that she will have a baby, a son that she is to name Jesus, meaning Savior, because he will save his people from their sins. Jesus, meaning the Lord, the Son of the Most High, is salvation. This child, which Gabriel announced, had long been awaited by the people of Israel. The prophet Isaiah had foretold of his coming.
In the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God.
Even so, Mary was surprised. She asked the angel how this could be true, since she was a virgin. The angel replied,
the Holy Spirit will come upon you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you. Therefore, the child to be born will be holy. He will be called the Son of God.
Sometime later, Mary hurried to a town in the hill country of Judea. There she visited with her cousin Elizabeth, who herself was pregnant with a child whose coming had also been announced by the angel Gabriel. Elizabeth's child would be John the Baptist. The song that Mary sings at this great moment of joy when she learns that she has been chosen to give birth to the Son of God is sometimes called Mary's Song. She sings of her thankfulness and her need for the Holy Spirit to draw near to her and strengthen her as she bears such an awesome and holy responsibility. She is a youth, a lowly handmaiden who was chosen above all others and will be called blessed by all generations.
A babe inside, and I wonder what I've done. Holy Father, you have come and chosen me now to carry your son. In a silent prayer, I am frightened by the load I bear in a world as cold as stone. Must I walk this path
with
watch my face if a wiser
Jesus Christ came about. His mother, Mary, was pledged to be married to Joseph. But before they came together, she was found to be with child through the Holy Spirit. Because Joseph, her husband, was a righteous man, did not want to expose her to public disgrace, he had in mind to divorce her quietly. But after he had considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary home as your wife, because what is conceived in her is from the Holy Spirit. She will give birth to a son, and you are to give him the name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophet: "The virgin will be with child and will give birth to a son, and they will call him Emmanuel," which means God with us. When Joseph woke up, he did what the angel of the Lord had commanded, took Mary home as his wife. But he had no union with her until she had given birth to a son, and he gave him the name Jesus.
In those days, Augustus Caesar issued a decree that a census should be carried out in the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinus was a governor of Syria, and everybody went to his hometown to register. So Joseph also went up from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because it belonged in the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pleased to be married to him and was expecting a child.
And while they were there, the miracle occurred. A child, a baby born in a stable, because better accommodations were not available to the young couple. In absence of a stable, in absence of a cradle, Mary placed the baby in a manger, in a trough used to feed animals.
Mary, did you know your baby boy would one day walk on water? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would save our sons and daughters? Did you know that your baby boy had come to make you new? This child that you delivered one day deliver you. Mary, did you know that your baby boy would give sight to a blind man? Mary, did you know that your baby boy would calm the storm with his hand? Did you know that your baby boy would walk where angels try? And when you kiss your little baby, you kissed the face of God. The blind will see, the deaf will hear, and the dead will live again. The lame will leap, the dumb will speak, praises to the Lamb. Mary, did you know that your baby boy, son of your creation? Did you know that your baby boy ruled all the nations? Did you know that your baby boy was heaven's perfect lamb? The sleeping child you're holding is the great I am.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in clothes and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth, favor rest." Great job. When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off, and they found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in her heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things that they had seen and heard, which were just as they had been told.
the first Noel, the angels did say, was to certain poor shepherds in fields where they lay, in fields where they lay keeping their sheep on a cold winter's night that was so
introduce to you a very good friend of mine. He's been a professor at Virginia University of Lynchburg. Come on up. Arian Benton is our guest soloist this morning. I was sitting in a service and I was sitting near this gentleman and I said, my oh my, what voice is that? And he's such a humble person. But when I asked him, he said, sure, I'd be glad to come and sing for you this morning. So would you welcome Arian Benton?
What wondrous love is this, O my soul, O my soul? What wondrous love is this, O my soul? What wondrous love is this that calls the Lord a bliss to bear the dreadful curse for my soul, for my soul, to bear the dreadful curse for my soul. When I was sinking down, sinking down, sinking down, when I was sinking down, sinking down, when I was sinking down beneath Christ's righteous frown, Christ laid aside his crown for my soul, Christ laid aside his crown for my soul. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing in joyful be, and through eternity I will sing, I will sing, and through eternity I will sing. To God and to the Lamb I will sing, I will sing. To God and to the Lamb I will sing. To God and to the Lamb who is the great I am, while millions join the theme, I will sing, I will sing. While millions join the theme, I will sing. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing on. And when from death I'm free, I'll sing in joyful be, and through eternity I will sing, I will sing. And through eternity
church say amen again.
Amen.
And through eternity I will sing. What wondrous love is this? That's why I love to tell the story. So just as the angels did when Christ was born, just as the shepherds did, just as the wise men came, O come, let us adore him. Let us sing Hosanna and give him the highest praise. Let us sing Hosanna to the King of Kings and Lord of Lords.
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
I love you,
love you.
You are the joy of my heart,
joy of my heart.
You are the strength of my life,
strength of my life.
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
you're worthy,
worthy
of all of the praise,
all of the praise.
Your majesty reigns,
majesty reigns.
Hosanna,
Hosanna,
you are faithful,
faithful.
You are always there,
always there,
to answer my prayer.
To God in the highest. You know, although we live in a world where sometimes peace and even joy seem so fragile and fleeting, because of this great gift that we have been given, the gift of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, we still can have peace, a peace that passes all understanding, a peace that the world does not share. We have this peace because we know the Prince of Peace.
Amen.
In him, we still proclaim peace on earth and goodwill to men. To a place, guide us with your grace.
Amen.
To a place where we'll be safe. I don't know about you, but I thank God for Jesus.
Amen.
This prayer that was just sung should be on every heart and mind.
Amen.
We should fall on our knees in awe and gratitude as we reflect on the Christmas story and the spectacular miracle that occurred on that holy night. And oh, what a night. What a holy, marvelous night.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the Spirit felt its worth. a thrill of hope. The weary world rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious morn. Fall on Eve, or hear the angel's voices, or night divine, or night when Christ was born. Oh, night divine, oh, night, oh, night to love one another. His law is love, and his gospel is peace. Chains he shall break, for the slave is a brother, and in his name all oppression shall cease. Sweet hymns of joy and grateful chorus raise we with all our hearts. We praise his holy name. Christ is the Lord. Then ever and ever we praise thee. His power and glory, yeah, ever proclaim.
Well, that's the story. There is none like it. When you think of it, doesn't it make you want to let the whole world know? Maybe this story has become old for some of you, but for me, it is everlasting. It never gets old. No matter how many times it is told, it is wonderful and inspiring and alive because the Savior who it is about is everlasting and he's wonderful and he's alive. Maybe it's just me, but I feel like rejoicing. I feel like telling it on the mountain. Do I have some people out there who would love to tell the story with me? If you would love to tell the story, say amen.
Amen.
If you love to tell the story, then sing along with us and let's go tell it on the mountain. Amen.